More about this with our CNN political commentators, Republican strategist Tara Setmayer, and also Mark Lamont Hill, of course, a professor at Morehouse College. Tara, let me begin with you. Again, as I said to Sondland, he brought this narrative in as a central part of his campaign, that God changed his life and changed his behavior. Now he believes that the media should not be delving into it the way that it is. Is that fair?
Listen, Ben Carson has made a lot of mistakes along the way, and I think a lot of what's happening right now is self-inflicted. The point you brought up, the fact that he has inserted these narratives into this public discussion, he brought them up. It wasn't like the press was digging around and they said, oh, here's this, what do you say about that? No, he has repeated these stories over and over again, and unfortunately for Dr. Carson, there have been a number of inconsistencies. This is not an isolated incident. So this goes back to what happens when you have an inexperienced political candidate, and it's clear that his campaign, the people he's surrounded with, are giving him terrible advice. The way they've handled this has exasperated the situation, and we just saw by what happened yesterday, they waited way too long for the response. That press conference, Ben Carson should have had his surrogates going out of their way to make those impassioned things. I mean, he was forced into having to answer these things now. It's been a debacle the way it's been handled. He has not been consistent, he hasn't been precise, and he's paying the price for it. Of course, blaming the media is an easy way to misdirect, because the media is easy fodder for particularly GOP primary
voters. Polling shows also that resonates really
sure
well.
Does.
With voters,
but
to blame,
that,
d- blame
but that
the
doesn't
media.
Excuse away the inconsistencies and the problems that Ben Carson has created for himself.
So, Mark, to you, looking at the issue of honesty here and trustworthiness, there's this new Quinnipiac poll taken before all these questions arose at the end of this week, and what it shows is that Carson was considered the most honest and trustworthy, not just among GOP candidates, but among all candidates, among Democrats as well. What does this do to that?
I think it's going to take a hit. It's inevitable that when a scandal or a faux scandal, however you want to frame this, comes up, that there is going to be some sort of dip in approval ratings and in trustworthiness ratings. I think in some sense, though, Ben Carson, and I hate to defend Ben Carson here because I actually think he's thoroughly unqualified to be president. But I think when he wrote that book 20 years ago or 30 years ago, he was telling the kind of tall tales in a ghostwritten book that many people do. He wasn't thinking about it as a presidential text. It wasn't like Dreams of My Father. It wasn't like The Audacity of Hope. It wasn't the type of book Hillary Clinton released last year. And I think he didn't anticipate that it would go through the kind of presidential vetting process that texts go through.
But he's talked about these stories, Mark.
Recently,
he's talked about these recently. He talked about being held at gunpoint at Popeyes, and then his campaign wouldn't give any details on that.
Yeah, no, I'm speaking specifically to the West Point story. I think that the Popeye story is absurd to me. I have deep suspicions about the knife stuff. I don't believe Ben Carson in general. I was speaking specifically about the West Point story. I think Politico may have overstated the amount of scandal attached to this particular thing. Frustration is there are so many other reasons to not trust Ben Carson. There are so many other reasons to say Ben Carson isn't worthy of being president, along with others. I'm not singling out Ben Carson here. But I think this particular story might be a little bit too much. But Ben Carson is wisely using it to his advantage.
So where do we go from here, Tara? I mean, he's neck and neck with Donald Trump in some of these national polls.
Listen, I think that as the process, now that he's getting the scrutiny that a presidential frontrunner should get and will get, I think that people will have to start to reevaluate Ben Carson. Unfortunately, because Politico, like Mark said, they were inflammatory, they misrepresented that West Point story, it has given Ben Carson cover to point and blame the media for this, as opposed to the credibility behind some of the legitimacy of these questions being asked. I mean, the Wall Street Journal did a piece posted last night, running today as well, where they laid out other instances in his books that were unverifiable from his time at Yale, where he claimed that he took a class and there was an exam that they had to take over, and he was the only one who took it over, and there was a picture. Mm. There's no picture. I mean, they list a couple of other incidents that we haven't been able to verify. So this is a problem for Ben Carson, but not necessarily for the people who support him. His support is pretty solid.
Yeah. We'll be watching. Tara, Mark, thank you very much. As always, I appreciate it. Still to come here, we have new details on those final moments on the Russian plane crash in Egypt, taking 224 lives. We now